Step 3. Creating the terrain. In this step, we will work with terrains. ArchiCAD's mesh tool enables the creation of terrain surfaces. Meshes are surfaces of any form created by defining the elevation of their points and interpolating between them. Activate the first preset view from the Creating Terrain folder of the Navigator view map. Select the mesh tool in the toolbox. Activate the Mesh 1 favorite in the Favorites palette. Switch to the Rectangular Geometry method in the Info box. Draw the mesh rectangle by clicking on the points of label 1.1 and label 1.2, which define the vertexes of the diagonal of the mesh. This is a mesh piece below the whole building, between the minus 6,000 and minus 4,400 levels. Activate the next preset view in the view map. Activate the Mesh 2 favorite in the Favorites palette. Space-click the contour of the mesh you just created near label 1.1. Hover your cursor over the horizontal edge you just clicked and hold down the Shift key. The Info tag appears. Also, a pre-selection highlight appears on the contour of the meshes. Notice the Multiple Elements tab text at the bottom of the Info tag. This means that there are more than one elements on top of each other. When this text appears, you can press the Tab key to shift between the elements, while still keeping the Shift key pressed. The Info tag and pre-selection highlight will cycle through all elements sharing the edge you are on. When you see the text Base Elevation minus 4400 appearing in the Info tag, shift-click to select this mesh. This is the one that you created in the previous step. Now space-click the white fill outline near label 1.2. In the Appearing dialog, choose the Create Hole radio button. Select the Fit to User Ridges option from the pop-up list. Click OK to proceed. A hole is now cut into the mesh. Activate the next preset view from the view map to open the 3D window. We now have a couple of more mesh elements to place in order to fill in some areas above the basement. Return to the floor plan by activating the floor plan icon in the Mini Navigator toolbar. Click the Escape key once to deselect the mesh, or click elsewhere on the floor plan window for the same result. Select the next preset view from the view map. Activate the Mesh 3 favorite in the Favorites palette. Space-click the contours of the light yellow fills near label 1.1 and label 1.2 to place two additional mesh elements. Select the next preset view from the view map. Activate the Mesh 4 favorite in the Favorites palette. Space-click the contours of the light yellow fills near label 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3 to place three additional mesh elements. Select the next preset view from the view map to display the completed terrain in the 3D window. Activate the last preset view from the view map to display the entire building with the terrain in the 3D window. Orbit around the model by using the Orbit 3D navigation mode to see what's been built so far. This concludes Chapter 5.